So to start, I need to chain 8. After you chain 8, slip stitch to join. And chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Make 11 double crochets in the ring. After making 11 double crochets, you now have 12 double crochets in total, and then you slip stitch on the top of the third chain. Now we're going for round 2. Now to start off round 2, you need to chain 3 and then double crochets in the same stitch. This is going to be the repeat, and you're going to do the same thing for all the 12 for the next 11 double crochets. So it's gonna be 2 double crochets in every stitch around. So after you make 24 double crochets in total, you're gonna do the same thing, slip stitch on top of the third chain to close. Chain 3. Double crochet in the same stitch. One double crochet in the next. So we're going to repeat this around. So after doing 2 double crochets and 1 double crochet in the next stitch, and you're going to repeat it around, you will have 36 double crochets in total. We're going to close off by slip stitching on the top 3 chain. And that's the end of the third round. Round 4, we're going to chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we're going to count this as our first double crochet and chain 3. And then we're going to skip the next stitch and double crochet in the next stitch. So we're going to skip 1 and then double crochet in the next stitch. Then we're going to chain 3. Do the same thing again. We're going to skip a stitch and then we double crochet in the next. And then we're going to repeat this pattern around. you finally get to the last double crochet, you chain 3 and then slip stitch on the third of the beginning chain. That's when you end round 4. Next is we're going to slip stitch into the first space. And then chain 3. 1, 2, 3. After you chain 3, you're going to make 2 double crochets in the same space. So, 1, 2. 2 double crochets. So now you have 3 double crochets, including the first chain that we did. 3 again. 1, 2, 3. And then 3 double crochets in the next. 7, we will do the same thing. We're going to slip stitch on the top of the 2 double crochets here, and then we're going to slip stitch in this space, chain 3, 2 double crochets, and then chain 3 again. So we're going to slip stitch first on top of the 2. Okay, to start off round 8, you're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and then you're going to double crochet in the next double crochet. And then in the next double crochet, 1 double crochet. And then in this space, we're going to do 4 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is our repeat pattern for this round. 3 double crochets and 4 double crochets in every space. Okay, so when you're done putting 4 double crochets in the last space, you're going to slip stitch on the top third chain, and then that's the end of this round. Okay, so round 9, we're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Then double crochet in the next 4 stitches. So So we're gonna put 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we're gonna put 2 double crochets in the next stitch. 1 and 2. So we're gonna do our increases now. After we put 2 double crochets in this stitch, we're gonna do double crochet in each of the next 5 stitches. So we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4. And then that is gonna be the repeat pattern. So after doing 5 double crochets and 2 double crochets as our increase, you'll end up with 2 double crochets at the end of the last stitch, and then you're going to slip stitch on top of the 3rd chain. So that ends round 9. Now in round 10, it's easier because we're just going to chain 3 and then double crochet in each of the next stitches. So that's the only pattern that we have for this round. 1 double crochet in each of the next stitch. Okay, so we're almost at the end of round 10, and also I forgot to mention that in round 9, there's an excess of 1 stitch. And so what I did is that the last 5 stitches, I put in, this is the 2 double crochets in 1 stitch, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But instead of putting just 5, I put another 1, 6. And then the last stitch, I made 2 double crochets because I noticed that even if my counting is right, I have an extra 1 stitch here and I don't know why. But in the next round, since I am following a written pattern, in the last 2 stitches, you're going to have a decrease. And you're going to do 2 double crochets together. So we're gonna do this to close off round 10, but we're going to have 1 decrease at the end, and then we're going to slip stitch on top of the 3rd chain. Okay, to start off with round 11 is like a repeat of round 1, 2, 3, 4, wherein we're going to start off with 3 chains. Chain 3, and then that is counted as a double crochet. And then 3 more chains, 1, 2, 3. So 1 double crochet and 3 chains, and then we're going to skip a stitch, and then next stitch we're gonna do double crochet. So that is a repeat pattern. We're gonna do 1, 2, 3 chains, and then skip a chain, and then double crochet to the next chain. We're almost at the end of round 11, so I double crocheted and second to the last stitch. If your counting is right, you'll have one stitch here. You will have one last stitch here. You're gonna skip that, but you're going to chain three first, and then slip stitch to the top third chain. All right, and that's round 11. Round 12, we're going to chain three, one, two, three, and we're going to double crochet in space. And then double crochet in double crochet. That's going to be the repeat pattern. We're going to do one double crochet in each space and one double crochet on top of the double crochet. Okay, so I've done one double crochet in the last space. Now I'm going to slip stitch to the top of the third chain to end round 12. So on round 13, we're going to do clustered of double crochets. So this is how we do it. We chain three first, one, two, three, and then double crochet in the same stitch. And then we're going to do chain two. And then two more double crochets in the same stitch. Okay, so two double crochets, two chains, or chain two, and then two double crochets. And then after that, we're gonna skip two stitches. So we're going to skip one, two stitches, and on the next stitch, skipping two stitches, we're going to do again two double crochets, chain two, and then two more double crochets in the same stitch. And you're gonna repeat that around. Now to start with round 14, we need to slip stitch until we get to the chain space, and then we chain three, one double crochet, chain two, two double crochets in the same stitch. So this is what we're going to do for the rest of the round. We will do two double crochets, chain two, and two double crochets in every shell or in every chain two spaces. To end this round, you're going to slip stitch on top of the third chain. So this is what it looks like. Okay, to start round 15, we're going to slip stitch until we get to the center of the shell. And then we chain one and then do a single crochet. We're going to do chain six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then single crochet in the next shell space. This is going to be the repeat pattern for this round. To close off the round, we're going to chain 6 for the last time, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we're going to do slip stitch the first single crochet. Round 16, we're gonna do slip stitch in the space, and then we're gonna do 8 single crochets. So we start off with one chain, or chain one, and then we do 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we're going to repeat that in every space. 8 single crochets. Okay, so to end the final round, we're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet that we made. And then we fasten off. Cut with scissors. Three. After you chain 3, double crochet in the same space.
Yeah.